Hi again. In this video, we are going to see how to create such a pattern in Grasshopper, this interlocking weaving pattern that you can use maybe in, as we can see here, maybe in facades or any kind of freeform or shapes that you are designing. So to start, we are starting with a freeform. For now, you can create any kind of form or like facade you're dealing with. And using this lunchbox plugin component, we are dividing the surface into its hexagonal cells. We will use the cells as well as the centers to the next step. Next step will be creating a filter. So we are saying that take each one of these cells, count how many points that we have, and if you have 6 points, which is like a full shaped hexagon, so you keep it. As we see here in the dispatch, we are keeping only the, I can show here, we are keeping only the closed shapes. We are applying the same filtering pattern on the cells as well as on the centers. So we can see like this, we are left only with the closed hexagons. Then the next step will be starting dealing with the weaving pattern. So what we are doing here is we are taking the center points of each of these curves. So we're taking this, this, and this in an alternative way. So we can, as you see, true, false, true, false, true, false. And we are linking or using these by themselves, then using these the others alone. Let me explain a bit more in 3D. So we are taking each one of these hexagons and exploding them, then introducing the point on curve, so the middle points, as we can see. Then we are taking an alternative pattern that the true false as we saw. We are taking maybe the first, the third, the fifth, and then the others alone. So these now are creating me like one list, and these are creating the other list. So in order for me to create this alternate pattern that some of them are connecting to a high point, some of them are connecting to a low point, we are going to the centers. We're using these centers of the cells, and we are introducing also like movement to each one of these centers. So the same distance, the same movement, but in different directions. So this one is moving upwards, Z value up, and these ones are moving Z value down. So if we can see, repeating here, we're taking the center points, moving one up, one down. Then I'm using the first group of points, which are like this alternative points, and connecting them with the point that is up. So this way I'm having this kind of shape. Then alternatively, I'm doing the same thing for the point that is down, which is like this. So this way we are having this kind of alternative weaving pattern. If we take a look on all of it, we are having the same thing that we aimed to create, then with some merging, as you can see here, the pattern is already applied. Then doing some cleaning trees and flattening the trees, we are also using an exoskeleton component, which turns all of these lines into surfaces. So this way we will have the continuous lines as continuous surfaces that connect to each other. Then using the weave bird smoothing tools, we are creating this kind of shape and subdivisions to make it a bit smoother. Then introducing different colors, we can as you can see, we can have the same weaving pattern that we aimed to have. And of course, we can control the numbers of cells. As well as the height of these distances. So the weave height distance as we can see. I hope this was a useful application. Please let me know if you use it in your designs or facades, and let me know if you need this script file. See you in the next one.